Hey everyone, I'm really excited for this build today. I've got fans everywhere, I've got cables everywhere, I've got 48 terabytes of hard drives. And the reason I'm really looking forward to this build is that for quite some time I've been consistently running out of disk space, but that ends today because this particular case can store up to 18 hard drives, which basically means it could store hundreds of terabytes of hard drives. And today I'm admittedly only starting with 48 terabytes of hard drives because I've got four 12 terabyte drives, but that's still going to be plenty for now. And in a previous video, I did discuss whether to go with Unraid or TrueNAS. I decided on Unraid just because there's some power saving features in there that I think are going to work out better for me than, you know, TrueNAS's ZFS file system, which runs the hard drives all the time. So that's my general plan. I'm going to be putting my YouTube videos on here once I'm done with them, and also probably storing some Linux ISOs too. But what about the hardware and why do I have a second computer here? Well, I actually bought this. It's a gaming machine from like 8 or 9 years ago. I bought it on Facebook Marketplace for £250 and it contains a GTX 1080, but I'm not going to be using that. Instead, I'm going to be using this, the Intel Arc B570, which might seem like a weird choice because this is a good graphics card, but actually I want to play around with AV1 transcoding and this graphics card supports that. And this was available for a very good price and gave me a Battlefield 6 key for free. So winner, winner, chicken dinner. In terms of the other hardware, I'm going to not use this all-in-one pump. I'm instead going to be using air cooling just because this is a, you know, a server build and I'm not a massive fan of, you know, all-in-one pumps in a 24/7 server build. But I'm going to be reusing the motherboard, the CPU and the RAM. The motherboard is a very good ROG Strix one. It's going to work out really well for me. It's got lots of SATA ports, PCI Express expansion and things like that. So it's perfect for a Homelab NAS build. And then when it comes to the CPU and the RAM, it's got an 8th gen Intel CPU, an i7, and also really fast 32 gigs, 3600 megahertz of RAM. This is completely overspecced for an Unraid build, but I figure, you know, if I'm going to explore transcoding and Docker containers and things like that, then actually, you know, going a little bit overboard with the hardware is never a bad thing. So that is that. And now I can get on with the build.
Conversation fading away. The way you smile, the way you walk, the time you took to teach me all that you had taught. Tell me, how am I supposed to move on? These days I'm becoming everything I hate. Wishing you were around, but now it's too late. My mind is a place that I can't escape your ghost. Sometimes I wish that I wish you. Brink of the edge, remember the words that you said, remember the life you led. You said, suck it all up, don't get stuck in the mud, thinking of things that you should have done. I'll see you again, my loved one.
Awesome, so that's done. And you know my favorite thing about the build? Being able to hear this. I'm so cool. But joking aside, there is something nice about the sound of spinning rust starting up, at least to me. So that's done, apart from the fact that I didn't have enough 140mm fans and I was waiting on a delivery when I actually done that build, and also the fact that I lost an M2 screw, meaning that one of my NVMe drives was just there dangling, doing nothing. But with the build, you know, almost complete, I could then move on to the Unraid installation. And it starts out normal enough. You get a USB pen and you install the Unraid operating system onto the USB pen. And you can do this in a manual way by, you know, downloading the image and then creating a bootable USB. However, they do also discuss having an automated method, and I was quite tired at this stage, so I thought I'll just do the automated method because that will be easier. But that was a mistake because the tool was a complete pain. Randomly, it would keep popping up with random windows. It would keep telling me to reformat the USB, even though I'd already done that, and then sometimes I'd format it, and then it would say, we can't proceed because you haven't formatted it. And there were loads of other issues where, you know, the download died halfway through. And also the first USB pen I used, it said it couldn't use at all because it didn't have a GUUID, and Unraid basically ties your installation to the USB pen they're actually using. But eventually on the second attempt, I actually found a USB pen that worked, and the download worked, and I had a USB pen. So I could then get my computer, I connected it up in this study, and then I basically booted into that USB. And in the BIOS, there's some settings you need to tweak, like, you know, having virtualization on. But once that's all done, I could boot up into Unraid, and it actually worked really, really well. And soon I actually seen the Unraid dashboard, which was a big sigh of relief because it meant that I'd actually done stuff and done it properly. So now I could actually carry my really heavy computer all the way to my garage, because this case is way too big to actually store in this room. And I also had a delivery for more M2 screws and the fan, so I put them in the system, screwed down the NVMe drive, and then I could set everything up. And I also have a UPS, which was in this room, but it wasn't really doing anything. So I moved that into my garage and I had my new Unraid NAS running through the UPS. And a UPS is a really useful thing to have because, you know, any area is going to have brownouts and little voltage fluctuations. We certainly see that here where every so often we get like a 1 second outage. And basically I don't want my Unraid NAS to instantly power down because that's bad for the hard drives. So yeah, everything was installed. I went to press the power button and nothing. Nothing happened. Nada. I don't exactly know why, but after some debugging and bringing it back up here, which was very, very annoying, I think it's actually a problem with the CMOS battery or the motherboard, which would be very bad. But I did swap out the CMOS battery and things seemed to be a bit more stable, so yeah. But either way, once I got it to a stable state, it was running in my garage, and then I could use any of my computers or my laptops to actually, you know, connect to the Unraid dashboard. So I went in there and immediately got even more confused, because there was a big shiny button saying start array, and I was like, I haven't set up any of my 4 hard drives or my 2 NVMe drives, but because there was that big shiny start array button, I clicked that. And then I actually went looking for how to configure, you know, my hard drives and my NVMe drives, and I couldn't find them anywhere. And again, this is a problem with me rushing ahead and wanting to press buttons instead of actually reading the manual, because what you should do is have the array stopped. Even though you don't have an array configured, the array of nothing should be stopped so you can then configure it. So I started off with the NVMe pool and it said, how many slots do I want? And I don't know what slots are. It didn't say that in the GUI. I'd done some Googling, but it wasn't completely obvious. But I knew that I wanted my 2 NVMe drives to be in like RAID 1, so I said 2 slots, and thankfully that seemed to work. Then it came to the actual array where I'm storing all my data, and as I mentioned in another video, I actually wanted to have that as a 2-drive parity, which means basically 2 of my drives can fail before I actually start losing data. So I went with 4 slots, meaning 2 sort of data drives or capacity drives, and 2 parity drives, and thankfully that worked as well. So I started then copying all of my YouTube content from my Synology NAS, which was very, very slow, but once that was done, I then actually did some test copies of media content from this computer to the Unraid NAS, and it worked as expected, so it went as fast as it could, considering I've got a 1 gigabit network right now. But I know that my hard drives can support more than that, so in the future, if I did upgrade, I think I need to upgrade 4 of my network switches to be 2.5 gig, then actually I would start seeing read and write speeds be closer to 2.5 gig than 1 gig. And that is a big relief, so then I started playing around more. And obviously I mentioned that I have some Linux ISOs that I want to watch on my TV, so I enabled Docker and Plex, and it worked absolutely flawlessly. I had no issues whatsoever. So that is brilliant. I'm actually really excited to have this build, because, you know, with like Synology or Ugreen, although that just works, you don't, I think, get the same sense of satisfaction as you do from actually building your own system and installing something like Unraid or TrueNAS on it. And personally, I'm happy I chose Unraid. I got some of my drives that are powered down when I don't use use them, so that's good for power saving. And I'm really glad that, you know, the Docker containers just work. So yeah, overall, I'm really happy. If you've got any questions or comments, please do leave them in the YouTube comments. And if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.